Welcome back to another episode of Love It There.
If you guys are new here, we are two sisters, Hallie and Kelsey, and we basically started this podcast because we love updating on each other on our latest travel adventures. And throughout our little bit of experience, we've come across some things that we wish we would have known going into certain places, and we figured it would be great if we could share what we learned with you guys. And in the second season that we've started, we've also been bringing on guests for people who have been to so many places that we haven't even dreamed of being able to go to. And so it's been great because we've been able to get to learn about new places with you guys as well. So this week we're talking about Copenhagen. But before we get into the actual travel content of the episode, we usually do little life updates to keep you guys in the loop of what's going on with our life, even though I don't know if anybody actually, we've gotten feedback that people like our little updates. So we're going to keep doing them until we get told not to.
Well, also it's to update each other because we are two busy gals. Hallie's in grad school and I'm working full time. So this is like our time to actually catch up with each other. So sorry that gets put into the beginning of each of our episodes. So if you don't like that, skip through it. But yeah, if you're here for whatever content we put out, that's great too. We're happy to have you.
Yeah. So this weekend, we actually had the privilege of being together because we went to the IU Michigan State football game, which is like our annual family rivalry football game because Kelsey went to Michigan State. I went to IU. So that was a really good time. And it was extra fun for me because IU won. So that was great.
Yeah. The Hoosiers are having a good season. So I'm happy to allow you guys to have the 9-0 record, but next year, Michigan State will get them back. It's always the away team. The past 4 years that we've done this family rivalry situation, the away team always wins. So yeah.
We're tied at 2-2.
So fun to the dynamic. Yeah. But yeah, no, yeah. We had a great weekend. Our parents come out for the game. Tailgate Trudy makes an appearance. So it's always a good time.
Yeah, so for those of you who don't know, you know how, like, a lot of people have, like, alter egos when they're drunk or, like, they'll get, like, fake names or, like, become, like, a different character? Well, whenever we go out with our mom, her name's Trudy, but whenever she drinks, she's Tailgate Trudy because okay, she
gets But she drink. Would be upset if you – she would want to pipe in here and say, I'm fun. I can be Tailgate Trudy even if I'm not drinking. So I True. Got you, Mom.
No, she has a great time always, but we love when she just, like, lets loose a little bit. It's great. It's great for everyone involved.
Yeah, no, it was super fun. It was a beautiful weekend, beautiful fall weekend. So, yeah, it was good. It was always good to see the fam, all that. So,
in other news, I know it's been a little bit since we've talked about our merch hoodies, and I'm sure there's a lot of you out there that are wondering what the update is on those. They will be here within the next couple of weeks, so stay tuned for more updates. We'll be keeping you guys in the loop. We originally said 6 weeks from the pre-order date, and it's looking to be like about that still. So everything's on schedule, but we'll keep you guys updated when we get closer to them actually being ready to be shipped to you guys. So yeah, but everything's looking great and we're so excited and I can't wait to see everyone in their Love It There hoodies. It's gonna make me so happy.
Yeah, I'm so excited for that. Thank you for your patience, everybody, with getting those, but we're excited for you to finally have them and post all your pictures in them and make sure you tag us. So But yeah, so today's episode is Hallie's friend Mira came on to talk about Copenhagen. You guys are going to love this episode. She's such a spontaneous traveler, as she'll talk about. But yeah, her Copenhagen trip sounded really cool. And Copenhagen, Hallie mentions this in the episode too. It's like one of Hallie's top places that she wants to go. And it just is so, I feel like it's different than a lot of other like classic Europe destinations. And Mira talks about this a little bit in the episode, but Copenhagen or Denmark specifically has this lifestyle or this, it's, they way have this, life. Yeah, they have this way of living that's called hygge. And it literally means, I looked it up because Mira talks about it a little bit, but I am just fascinated by this because Copenhagen is one of the, or some, and according to some people, it's the happiest city in the world, the happiest place to live. And a large part of that is this like hygge lifestyle that they live by. And so it's a feeling of contentment. It's a Danish and Norwegian word that describes a feeling of contentment and coziness that comes from being comfortable and convivial. It's about taking time to relax and enjoy life's simple pleasures with people you care about. So yeah, that's just like so cute and so wholesome. And Mira talks about that when she was there, that you could just tell people were just kind of like chilling and enjoying life with themselves, with each other. So I don't know. I think that's really cool. So today's episode is all about that. And she gets into a whole lot more too about like a day trip to Sweden you can take from Copenhagen and must try restaurants and parks to go to. So you guys are going to love this episode.
All right. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into today's episode on Copenhagen. All right, Mira, welcome to Love It There. To start, we ask all of our guests just to tell us a little bit about yourself and how you like to travel.
Okay, yeah. So I'm Mira. I grew up with Hallie going to high school. So, well, not grew up, but we went to high school together.
That was like growing up.
Yeah. Yeah. It's been a long time. And I would say my travel is really sporadic. Like, I will book a flight very quickly if someone were to give me, I guess, like the time and place. And I kind of will look for like the cheapest deals, but I think my mom just instilled in me that like once in a lifetime opportunities are only like once in a lifetime. So I would say I'm a little rare in the way I like will spend a little more as a broke college post grad. So I wouldn't say it's the smartest way of travel if I'm being honest, but I would say I'm very like
you're sporadic. Very spontaneous.
Yeah, yeah. I would say like someone asked me to make time, I would make time and I would like go somewhere.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Well, speaking of that, kind of tell us how, so we're talking about Copenhagen today. So tell us about how that trip kind of came to be and the story of that. Yeah. 'Cause I feel like that's a very good example of how you like to travel.
No, definitely. I was at just like I had a friend come into town and he hosted like a little get together at his house. And so he's actually my boyfriend's friend, and I went like with my boyfriend, and their friend was kind of just telling us how she's planning on going to Europe for like 2 months just on her own over the summer. And I was just asking her where, because I am very curious about that. And she was just giving me kind of like a, I don't really know yet, but like, I'm just planning it right now. You should come. And I was kind of like, okay, like when are you going? Like, what's the best dates? Like, where are you planning on going? And she was like, well, I'll just like update you on where, if you like really want to come. And then a couple weeks
later. And you
like
didn't really know this person that well.
No, like did not know her. Like really just through, it's actually my boyfriend's older sister's friend. So like not even really my.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. And she kind of was just like, yeah, like if you're interested, I'll let you know like where and when. So I gave her kind of like the best dates I thought were going to be available. And then she let me know where, like when she was going to like her places and like what her plan was. And then from there, I just like bought the ticket and flew into Copenhagen.
Oh my gosh.
And then I did a week there and then we did a couple days in Amsterdam. But I very much like did not know her super well. Like we could have hated each other and I've been stuck with just her, but we ended up really loving each other. So that was so fun. But,
oh my gosh.
Yeah. And I thought maybe someone else was going to join us, but then they weren't. And so it was really just us too.
That's so funny. I like love that though.
No,
like,
I do too.
I love the spontaneity. And I think it like, I don't know, it's like chaotic, but then it's like you get all these great experiences just by like saying yes to things that like a lot of people wouldn't say yes to.
Well, yeah, and we were like drinking when she told me, so I was like, oh, this is maybe just like a little like, you know, just a social conversation of just like
where she's like, oh, you should totally come with me, but really it's like did she actually want me to come, because I'm booking my flight.
But yeah, like yeah, I'm actually going,
I actually will go with you.
Yeah, So sorry, you shouldn't have said that if you didn't want me to come.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm actually coming.
Yeah. So how did you guys decide? Did you choose Copenhagen and like the spots, or like had she like maybe wanted to go to these places and then you were like, okay, cool, that sounds good?
Yeah, yeah. So as she got closer to like her trip, she had planned, like she was like, I'm gonna go to this for, I think she saw Taylor Swift, and then she was like, and then I plan to go to Copenhagen for these days and then Amsterdam for these days.
What Amsterdam time of year and was Copenhagen this? Are both like places that I've said like are next on my list of like I really want to go because I want to hit some of like the more northern spots. And so when you said you were going there, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so jealous.
It was cool. It was in the summer, so it was September. It was like the end of August to early September.
Okay. Yeah, I feel like that's a good time to go. How cold was it? What was the weather like?
It was not cold at all. Like it got like kind of cold when it got dark, like when the sun went down, but I was in like pretty much like shorts and a tank top.
Okay.
I threw on like a cover up. But what I didn't realize was they're super like trendy in Copenhagen. Like when I first flew in, I was wearing like the Free People like hotshot like onesie. And I literally looked so out of place. And I felt, I was like, I know I'm wearing like nice clothes, but like I got there and people were walking off the plane in like blazers and like nice pants. Like I stepped out.
Yeah, that's intimidating.
It was, like, so trendy, slick back buns and like big sunglasses.
Oh my gosh.
So ahead of the trends everywhere. Like it wasn't even like, even in the grocery store, I'm like, you look so good right now.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
So I was very like, oh my gosh, they can definitely tell I'm new here because I'm walking around in like this like pajama, almost like comfy set and like no
but
one.
But it's funny because like that's like cute and trendy here. Not like, because I know what you're talking about. And like for people that don't know, it's like, that's like,
it's like
a trend right now. Like what she's talking about is these like big, like flowy overalls basically.
Yeah.
And, but it's just
it's a good travel fit
like,
for sure.
Yes.
Yeah, it's
it,
a great
it was,
fit.
But I was literally like, I know I'm wearing like something nice, but I like don't look like I am compared
so
to these
funny.
People.
Okay. So what were your like overall thoughts before we get into like the specifics of Copenhagen? I'm assuming you liked it because you said you wanted to talk about it. So I'm assuming you had a great experience, but like maybe even like compared to Amsterdam a little bit, like what were your overall thoughts?
Yeah, I would say the people in Copenhagen were so nice. Like it wasn't, I didn't feel like I was like, even though I did feel like I was like out of place, like no one like looked at me like I was.
Yeah.
And everyone was super helpful because I got there like hours before or like pretty much I got there in like the morning and my friend got there like in the evening, like after dinner time. So I had like the whole first day to myself to just walk around. She had like our like place or like hotel reservation. So I like didn't even, I couldn't even like check in. So I just like checked my luggage there. And then I just walked around on my own. I got food on my own, but everyone was like extremely helpful. Like I remember asking people like what are the like must do things here, like I'm here for a couple days, and they were like, oh, you definitely have to like bike around, you have to like go on walks, like it's definitely like a very slow and like just easy way of living. I can tell that like people had there. It's one of the happiest places in the world, I'm pretty sure. It was, I could
did
just
you,
tell
like so
people
you felt
just
that?
Were unbothered. Yeah, like people were just so unbothered. Like I'm just such an impatient person too. And like, I would just get like annoyed if like there was a slow walker or something. And I just could tell like no one else was annoyed.
That's interesting. Well, okay. So you mentioned the biking. So let's talk about that a little bit. Cause Copenhagen's like the biking capital of the world. So did you do some biking and truly like, is it like there's more people biking than in cars, or like how extreme is the biking situation there?
Yeah, there were so many people biking. I was almost scared too because they like seemed like they knew how to ride a bike better than they like drove cars. Like that's how it felt. Every time like I wasn't being mindful of a bike lane, like people were very nice, but it was very much like this, you don't
respect
stand in
the bike
lane. Like do not stand in the bike lane. So when we did rent bikes from the place we were staying. And we just went to a park because we didn't want to like actually try it on the road. It was just there's so many people who just knew what they were doing and we just didn't know what we were doing. So we went to a park and we biked around the park, and that was kind of our like biking experience, but it was really fun. Like, just, I don't know, I felt like I was a part of like a, like almost a run club.
Yeah.
But like, it was people biking.
A part of like the culture.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. So do people bike in the roads, or is it like, why is biking so popular? Do they have a lot of bike lanes, or is it
just really flat? Okay. Like, is that why it's easy to get around on bikes?
Or? I don't know why it would be easy to get around on bikes, but they have like made specific like bike lanes. Like we were talking about this when we were there, like the encouragement on like biking and like public transportation and like walking, like, is just, they made it easy for them to do. Like, the bike lanes are as big as the sidewalk, where that's why I got confused, honestly, because it was that big where I could like thought that's where I was supposed to be walking. And it's like, even people would, they have like bike, you know, like at stoplights, like how they have the walk sign, and they like always had a bike sign. So like, to keep the bikers like from going or stopping.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's so cool.
So it's probably much safer to bike in Copenhagen than it is to bike like in any major city in the US, or, you know, because they just have those things put in place where they're making it safer with like the stoplights and bike lanes and stuff like that.
Well, my question is, obviously you weren't there in the winter, so you might not know, but what do people do in the winter? Because it obviously gets very cold there.
True.
It's very far north. So that's why it's just like shocking to me that biking is like so big there, because it's not like it's like Spain.
I mean,
like,
people were biking in the rain too. Like, it wasn't even like the weather didn't seem to stop them from biking.
Oh my gosh, I would never do that.
Well, and Mira, you mentioned something about like they push like public transportation and stuff like that. And so my husband Jackson, he went to Copenhagen for just like a couple days when he was studying abroad in Budapest. And he asked before we were recording today, he's like, oh, what are you guys talking about today? I said, Copenhagen. I said, do you have any like thoughts about it that you want me to like put in or anything? And like, one of the first things he said was how clean the air was. He's like, that's just like what first came to my head, was like, just like breathing that air just felt so like crisp and fresh. And it's probably because like they don't have as much like cars and pollution that other major cities would, because there's like more people just biking, like commuting on their bikes.
Yeah. I do know they like pride themselves on their like water. Like, they are like, we have the best like drinking water in the world. Like, they'll like say that, and like, you can drink it out of the sink, out of like, they have like some stations set up. Especially like, there was one by the really popular colorful houses, it's called Nyhavn, I believe, and someone might be able to tell me actually how to say that better. I tried
that
to
sounded great,
say
yeah.
it. But yeah, and they had like a drinking water, like a water station, and it's literally like, just, you can get it out of a sink, you can get it out of those stations in the ground. They like pride themselves on their water. So, I mean,
that's cool.
Don't know so much about the air, but the water was really good.
Yeah.
I feel like it'd be one and the same. If you have clean air, you got to have clean water, and vice versa. Yeah. So, okay, the like strip of colorful houses. So, I feel like that's like, if anybody's seen a picture of Copenhagen, that's what they've seen a picture of. Is it truly just like a short strip, or is that like what the homes and apartments look like in Copenhagen? Or is it truly just that like one little area?
That is the most colorful area, I will say. Like, I would say all the other homes look like the style of the building, but they're not as like colorful or just as like photogenic, honestly.
Yeah. Okay.
But definitely those, and that whole area, I was even like asking people when I got there that first day, like, what do I have to do, like, you know, to get the most out of this? And they were saying, go to that strip, but only tourists are there. Like, no one who's like a local Copenhagen native, like, they are not hanging around there.
Because what is everything there to do there?
Like, the only thing is they have like canal tours, and then there's restaurants like in those buildings and like places people stay. I did not obviously stay there, because I'm sure it was very overpriced, just for like,
because
that's like that's the spot you see, that's what people know.
Is that like the main downtown area of Copenhagen?
I couldn't really tell, honestly, what downtown was, because we were just walking through like strips and like alleys and all that, of just like different shops and different like places to eat. Like, it felt like every turn I made was like a big popular area. So I didn't really know what downtown was, but that was definitely a really popular area. But all I really saw there was like the canal tours, and like, there were some restaurants to eat at. A lot of people like had their own like boat there, like some houseboats and stuff.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Tell us more about the canal tours, because I have seen stuff about that online, mm-hmm. but like, is it just like literally a tour, or is it like dinner on the boat?
It's just a tour. It's okay. Almost like, have you ever been to like Niagara Falls?
Yeah.
Like, if you've gotten on those boats, it's just like rows and rows of seats and then just someone like telling.
So it's like sightseeing.
Yes.
Okay.
Pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah. But it's like they're
big. Did you do one?
And no, we did not. We were considering it, but they weren't that expensive, honestly. Like, I want to say it was like $20, but they were about an hour and the lines just were so long. Like, everyone there wanted to do it.
Yeah.
And so
yeah,
I just felt like if we could just walk it, we could. I mean, it's
or like hiked along.
Yeah.
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 Is there like a name of like neighborhoods or like area or like different areas? Do you know where you stayed, or do you have like a special place that you would like recommend? Oh, we didn't stay there, but this would have been good to stay, or anything like that.
Yeah, we stayed on, I think it was called Vesterbro, and it was just like one of the stops, like it, on the train from the airport. Like, we just got off and it was like probably, it was less than a mile from that train station. And that had like a lot of the like foods we looked up where we were like where to eat, like that was kind of where we stayed.
Okay.
So that like strip on Vesterbro had a lot of good foods to eat. We were by a like pastry shop, and the big thing is like a Danish pastry.
Yeah.
So
my mom, the first day I was there, I like called my mom. I'm like, look where I am. And I was showing her all the houses, and she's like, you have to go get like a Danish pastry because you're in like Denmark.
Yeah.
Right.
So I was like, oh my gosh, you're right. So I went back near where we were staying and I got one. And honestly, so good.
Really?
Like,
what did you get?
I don't know if I like built it up in my head, like, oh, I'm in like Copenhagen.
So it's gonna taste
better.
But it was literally just like a cream filled like Danish. Like,
yeah.
It wasn't anything crazy I got, but I just remember like thinking like, you know that Ratatouille scene where he has like the cheese and the like, yeah. I was like, oh my gosh, this is the best thing I've ever eaten.
I like feel like that's valid though. Like a Danish pastry,
like
that's gotta be good.
Everybody has a story like that. Like, that's like my cannoli from Venice that I still think about, that it was like the best thing ever. And I'm like, Now thinking back on it, I'm like, was it actually that good, or was it just because like I'm in Venice eating a cannoli and it was
you're
the
like
best
romanticizing
thing ever.
It in your
yeah.
head
because yes.
you like think it's gonna be the best thing in the world, but
right.
I'm sure it was really good.
Yeah,
yeah.
No, and also all I had to like compare it to was literally like a Starbucks Danish.
Right.
So like,
oh, yeah,
I'm so sad of us because I'm like the same way. But yeah,
what were some other like food specific to like Copenhagen or Danish foods that people told you to try or that you did eat?
They didn't give us like a specific meal, but a big like food place they recommended was this place called Reffen. And you have to, well, you can drive to it, but the best way to get to it is through a ferry. It's literally like a 4-minute ferry ride. And
wow.
It's just like this almost like little like island, but not far. Like, it's just like, because you can drive to it, it just takes like 40 minutes compared to like a 4-minute ferry ride.
Okay.
And it's just this like island almost of like old storage units that have been turned into like different restaurants.
Oh my gosh.
And yeah, so it's on in the water, like on the water, and people can like swim. It was a little too cold because we went in the evening to like swim, but
whoa.
It had like all different kinds of foods. Like, I had like Greek food there, but there was like American food, Mexican, Pakistani, like Indian, like literally all you can name. And it was just like different like storage units turned into food places. And it was like,
that's cool.
Yeah, it was like a little, I'll have to like send the pictures because I took videos. It was like a little almost like party because they had like a bunch of like picnic tables set out where people ate. And it was huge. I mean, it was like, you literally took a ferry just to like go to this place called Reffen.
Yeah.
And so,
yeah.
Oh my gosh, but you have to go hungry. And actually someone, when I like posted on my Instagram that I was there, someone slid up and was like, you have to go to this place, Reffen. So on top of
wow.
like, people there telling me to go, like
even
I had
tourists.
Other people. Yeah. I had like other people saying, and they were like, you have
locals
to go hungry
tourists.
Too. But oh my gosh, it was so much food and it was so good. And like, you just see, like, you look out on the water and like, I don't know, it was, and they had like lights. And then I believe also when it gets like later, they have like more of like a party club scene there. Like,
oh, cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So cool. That's just like so
that
unique.
Sounds so fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. Being right on the water too. I'm sure it was so pretty.
That's so
But
funny.
Even being able to like ride the ferry over is cool too. That'd yeah. be fun.
Okay. So you talked about like must-do food. What would be like a must-do activity or something to see while you're in Copenhagen?
Yeah. Well, definitely Nyhavn. That mm-hmm. is a big one.
And that's the colorful houses you said?
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
And then we just like did a lot of park sitting. The park we went to was called Frederiksberg Park. And if you walk around it enough, there's an elephant lookout point that like you can see the Copenhagen Zoo. And it's for like it's free because it's in the park, but you can just see like the elephants from that zoo.
Oh, that's so cool.
Went and like looked at the elephants, and that's also the park we like biked around to.
So is it pretty big?
Yeah, it was pretty big, yeah. And like so many people. I just love this about just European culture, like the park culture. Like people are just sitting out, like doing mm-hmm. whatever. Running is really big there too. Like there were so many run clubs and so many people just running around.
That was something else that Jackson said, is that he's like, when you're there, it's not surprising that everybody there is like thin, because like biking and running and just like people just like aren't driving in their cars. They're like, yeah, they're moving their body all the time. So yeah, that's interesting.
Which I wonder if that is like what causes everyone to be so happy there. Like I wonder if it's just because like everybody's getting fresh air all the time and like has the freedom to like move their body and like actually get out of the house sometimes, where I feel like it's like not always the case here. So
yeah, they have like a whole like motto. It's called, and I'm gonna mess this one up, but I'll spell it out, hygge. I thought it was like higgy, but it's actually like hygge. And it's literally like, it's a Danish state of contentment. Like it comes from Denmark, specifically Copenhagen.
Wow.
And they have them like on t-shirts and hats, like especially in the more touristy areas, you'll see people like advertising like shirts that say like hygge on it.
And, like, yeah,
it's literally just a state of contentment, and that's like their lifestyle. They like are like living this like hygge lifestyle.
That's so cool. I love
that's
that.
Inspirational, honestly.
I wish
that we could bring that here.
Well, when my friend finally arrived, she was like, I can't wait to like experience like the hygge lifestyle. And I was like, what is that?
You're like who is this girl that I'm here with?
Yeah, you're like, am I regretting showing up with this random girl? No, that's cool though. Wait, okay, speaking of the girl that you were with, wait, sorry, I feel like we should like name
her. Okay, her name is Riley.
Okay, because I'm with this girl. So Riley, you sent me a video of her like travel itineraries that she had on her Google Maps.
Yes. Okay, so she also, and I know Kelsey, you've done this and maybe you did this, she also like didn't buy like the international phone plan, and she was there for 2 months. So I was like,
oh my gosh,
if anyone deserves to buy it, like you deserve to buy that. But
But
she did not buy it. She just went off Wi-Fi. But on her maps, like her Apple Maps, she would pin like different things and add it to her guides. So you can like drop pins on Apple Maps and create a guide. And then like without Wi-Fi, like if you click on like your Copenhagen guide, it shows all the like locations you've like pinned, and you can like, it'll like route you to it like without Wi-Fi. So everywhere she went that she really liked, like food places or just like the things she thought were super cool or must do, she would like pin it and then like create a guide on her maps.
And then you can share your guides with other people too. So then you can like save all the places that you went. So then if you have like people that you know that go there in the future, you can just like send them your guide of all the places that you've been.
Oh, that's so nice.
I know.
Wait, that's on Apple Maps only, not Google Maps?
Oh, I don't know. I don't use Google Maps.
This might convince me to switch.
Love Google Maps.
I mean, I'm sure it's like a thing on Google Maps, but we just used Apple Maps.
I need to look into this.
So then I just started like doing it with, I just even like recalled other trips I took, because I was like, I want to have all these like saved for if I ever like recommend to someone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you ever go to Tivoli Gardens? Is that how you say it?
Yes. No, we did not go there.
Okay.
I think it's just like an amusement park.
Yeah.
And it was kind of, when I was there, someone told me like, oh, it's cool, but it's also just an amusement park.
Right. So, and I feel like if you're there for a short amount of time,
it wasn't like, might not really be worth something it. We and the whole admission was like so expensive. It's honestly very expensive there. Like okay. everything, all our meals, if we like ate out, it was like probably a little over $30. Like okay. even just to get mm-hmm. something small. And so we were just very like trying to be, she was more cautious because she had been in Europe at that point for like over a month right. and had been right. spending alarm. I was more like willing. I was just ready to go wherever and
yeah.
do whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, like our coffees were all like $7 and like just, I mean, wow. this much. Like yeah. not a right. lot. And so it wasn't really something we had interest in doing. I'm not like, I don't really mind amusement parks. Like I'll go if everyone wants to go. Yeah. But if she was like, I don't really like roller coasters or like right. amusement parks, then I was like, okay.
Well, the reason I asked is because I was like looking up basic stuff about mm-hmm. Copenhagen just to like get an idea of it, because obviously I've never been like anywhere near Copenhagen yeah. so I was just like trying to get familiar a little bit with it, and like that came up and I saw something that said that like Walt Disney visited mm-hmm. Tivoli Gardens and that was like his inspiration for Disney World.
Yeah, like I wow. I also remember seeing something like that because it had a very similar like just like the fun, like childlike, like there was like a place right next to it that like was like a gift shop almost, and all of it like kind of reminded me of like Disney. Like you could buy like a lot of knickknacks like that okay. kind of reminded me of like something that you would see at Disney.
Yeah.
So yeah. But we did not go. I think it was more just like, what are we just gonna like walk around or,
no that's like, so yeah. fair. Like I feel like yeah. I probably wouldn't have gone there either, but I just like was seeing a lot about it, so I was yeah. curious if you went. So we talked about food a little bit with the culture. Were there any mm-hmm. other big like cultural differences that were shocking to you or you weren't expecting? Or
well, like I said, the fashion, like everyone yeah. was super trendy, and even going into like stores, like it was all like really high end stuff. Okay. Like it was mm-hmm. there wasn't like a, I mean there was like an H&M, like, where's Target? Or yeah, there was, but like we like no one was in there. Like we went to the H&M and I was like, oh, no one's here.
You're like, I gotta all, go.
They're all at like these high end
where I get called yeah. out for being a tourist. Yeah.
And like when I went in there, the only person I talked to spoke English. So I'm like, oh, and like not in an accent, like yeah. English. Yeah. I was like, oh, you're definitely also a tourist.
Yeah. Like,
there was another place I'm trying to, oh, it was called like the Flying Tiger, I believe that's what it was called. That was a chain, and it was like a Five Below almost, but like more expensive. Okay. But like it had yeah. like all these like
oh,
fun
wait,
little
what is it?
Flying Tiger, or maybe like Tiger's Eye. Does Tiger's Eye yeah. sound familiar?
There was like something like that in Spain, like mm-hmm. everywhere. We saw them everywhere, and it was like I could tell it wasn't like a Spanish yeah. brand, and it was like a Five Below type thing.
Yes. Yeah. I mean they sold like literally like notebooks, pens, but then like random kitchen utensils, and it was like a fun store you could just walk around and be like, oh, this is like interesting and unique. And like Riley was very much like, we have to go into a Flying Tiger or yeah. like a Tiger's. I can't even remember what it's, now I have to like look
no,
it up.
No, it's definitely because what was in Spain yeah. though, because I know exactly what you're talking about.
Okay, maybe it is Flying Tiger. Yes, it is called Flying Tiger. Yeah. Yes. And it's like just this Danish brand of like just items, I guess. Like that was something she was like, we have to go in because it's like Danish, so yeah. we have to be here. And
that's
so
funny.
I'm trying to look if there's anything else I put. Okay, yes, so there is another park that I would recommend. It's called Kongens Have, and it literally is like, I don't even know the best, but it has like a great, it's right by Nyhavn, so you can kind of see like the houses, but it also like it is a great, like, another picture, I guess, spot for, like, the tall houses and those buildings that you kind of know Copenhagen for. There was a lot of, like, I would say college, like, age kids or, like, high school kids. Another thing about that, I need to look into this a little more. There were, like, people who looked like they were in high school, like, just walking around on, like, a Tuesday. And I was like, why aren't you in school right now?
Yeah. So maybe they, like, don't start till later.
I don't know.
Yeah that's interesting.
But they were playing this, like, really funny, like, drinking game because, like, it's just so common to, like, bring a bottle of wine to, like, the park and, like, sit and just drink it openly. It was – I can't remember exactly what it – oh, they put a bottle in the middle, and it was, like, I want to say, like, 15 kids on one side and 15 on another, and they put, like, a bottle in the middle, and then they each took turns with their shoes trying to hit the bottle, and if they hit the bottle – the other team would, like, have to drink until the other person, like, grabbed.
Wait, that's, like, the drinking game. Have you ever played it, like, at a tailgate when you have, like, the cans on the corner of the table?
Yes,
and you
beer,
take a ping
beer
pong
ball.
Is that what it's called? Why can I not remember what it's called?
Wait, I think you taught me that game.
Wait.
I swear you taught me this.
No, I think I did call it beer ball, but
that's what my friends call it.
I just played it this past weekend when I was at IU for homecoming, and they definitely were calling it a different name. So now I'm, like, all confused. But it's, like, the same
but
game.
I mean, not really, because it was literally, like...
But on a bigger scale, because you're
just, like, at a park. Yeah, at a park, like, you're almost separated and, like, capture the flag teams. But you're just, like, lined up facing the other, like, team. And you're just throwing your shoe
at
this bottle.
That is so funny.
And if you hit it, your team, like, starts drinking. And then, like, the other team has to run and, like, put the bottle up or something.
Oh.
And they played this game. Like, we went to the parks multiple days, and like I would say 2 out of the 3 days we were there, like we saw like a group of kids like playing this
that
game.
That is so funny.
So wow. I don't know what I don't
somebody
know
somebody that's like
is.
Watching on the YouTube needs to give us a comment and
yes.
let us know
yes.
like what this game
yeah.
is. I think
what
I took
do
a video
this
of
game
because I was like, I don't know, is this weird that I'm filming them? But like
I did that stuff so, all the time in Europe, and I was like, people think I'm like a stalker for sure.
I was like, this is just so like I don't know. And it also just seemed like we were just watching these groups of people because we were like, what if we just like went and joined them?
Yeah.
But it seemed like they all did not know each other. Like they were all like introducing themselves, and then they play this game and then they'd go back and like really like get to know each other.
That's so funny.
Wait, okay. Hallie though, talking about the YouTube comments though, because yeah, so we've had like people on our YouTube that comment in like whenever we talk about stuff and we're like, I think this is what it's called, you know, I don't know, whatever. Our YouTube listeners or watchers or whatever are very helpful actually in like correcting us when we say things wrong or telling us like, oh, this is like what you guys were trying to describe. And please, like we welcome that. Like by no means, we've never
we
said
not
that we
think
are
we're
experts.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tell us what this game is.
Yes. Whenever we like have people on the podcast or just me and Hallie talking about like, it's just like us talking about our trips. We're not trying to be experts on this.
We do this podcast for the purpose of learning. So please educate us because we're trying to learn more.
Or if you're just like listening on audio and you like, you know, have something to add or correct us, just like DM us on Instagram or fill out the little like contact us thing on our website. Like, please, we welcome those sort of like critiques, I guess, or just like inputs from you. So,
for
but
sure.
Also, talking about like the parks and stuff, because I literally just saw this thing on Instagram that it was like why you like feel so depressed when you come back to the US after being in like Europe and stuff like that. And it's because Europe does a good job of the third spaces, which are like somewhere other than home and somewhere other than work that you can go to like meet with people.
That makes so much sense. Like we spent like hours in this park. Like that's why I was a little nervous because I was like, am I going to actually have a lot to share? Because a lot of it was just like sitting and like drinking a cup of coffee and like reading a book in a park and just like enjoying like the view.
I love that too. Yeah.
And I was very much like, yep, this is that hygge lifestyle because if this is what I could do like every day. I would totally do it.
Yeah. Well, and just like feeling like that's okay to do because it's like that sounds so enjoyable to me, but I have a really hard time. And maybe this is a me thing. I don't think it is, but I just have a really hard time like letting myself relax when I feel like there's always like a million things to do. Mm-hmm. But if it's like a cultural thing that like, no, that's what everybody goes to do. Like when you're not working, when you don't have to be at home, like they like cherish that time of relaxation and just like being out in nature. And so I feel like letting yourself do that when there's like so many people around you doing it would be like so much easier. But,
well, another thing I was going to say on that is I remember everyone like ate outside. Like even if it was like raining, they were under like a tarp. But like if there was indoor seating, that was like last case. Like if every seat outside was full, like people moved inside. And another thing I remember when we were at this place getting food, there's like certain like cafes you're like not allowed to have a laptop. Like you can't be working on a laptop.
Oh my gosh.
Which I bet like enforces that like you have to like kind of sit and relax.
Yeah.
Like,
right.
There's some places that are specifically designed to like don't
you, can
you
work
can't
here,
yeah,
you can't work here.
I did have another thing of like if you are visiting Copenhagen, what you should do is you should do a day trip to Malmo, Sweden. It's like a 40-minute train. and the train goes over. I was looking this up. It's called the Øresund Bridge, and it basically is this like bridge that separates the Baltic Sea and the North End Sea. I think North End is Sea is the right one, or North Sea. And the whole like train ride, you are like pretty much over this bridge. You get to see like the water. Oh. And the view is like crazy. I mean, if you're scared of bridges, don't do it, because it's actually like kind of terrifying for those kinds of people. Like, I think Riley was really nervous, but I was like, this is amazing. Like, looking out the window the whole time. Gosh. And yeah, and then you can take a whole trip to like Malmo, Sweden. And that place is really cool too. So if you ever have someone who wants to talk about that, or I could talk about that. I just wasn't there long enough, so I can't really share that much. But that it's like such an easy like day trip that people do.
Yeah, because I was looking on the map and I didn't even realize like how close Copenhagen was to Sweden. Like it's kind of separated from the rest of Denmark on its own little island.
Yeah.
And then it's like closer to Sweden. Yeah.
It was funny when we were in Sweden because, oh, another huge thing. Sorry.
No, this is great.
Thrifting. No, you're buying. Thrifting is huge there. Like they love buying secondhand things. And I was at a cafe and this girl was wearing a Purdue shirt, and Riley went to IU, and a huge IU fan. So I like was making jokes before, like, I bet I'll see a Purdue thing. Like, cause I was wearing my Purdue sweatshirt a lot. So I'm like, I just bet I'll see something. And randomly I saw a girl and she was wearing a Purdue shirt. So I went up to her. I was like, oh my gosh, did you go to Purdue? And she was so confused. She was like, what? She's like, I bought this secondhand. I'm sorry. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh my God. She didn't even like know what the sweatshirt was.
No, she didn't even know. And I was like, that's my like college.
Wait, that's crazy.
And she was like, I just bought this secondhand. Like, I don't know what you're talking about.
That is wild. I wonder if like her name started with a P and she was just like, oh, P for whatever, my name. And that's why she wanted to get it.
It said like Purdue on it. It was honestly a very
fully Purdue.
Yeah, like sorry to the girl. It was so ugly. Like it was like a very ugly Purdue like shirt.
But she was rocking it.
But they're trendy. Yeah, so maybe you just can't recognize the good like
time. Yeah, I guess. But I was just like, you know, some study abroad kid was like, I can't bring this back, and left it. Right. And then she like
bought too much in Denmark and had to not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She had to weed out her suitcase a little bit. So she's like, I'll just leave this here. Yeah.
But they like are really big on, like, we went to a couple thrift stores, and even those items were really like expensive. But
well,
like,
I was gonna say, it's funny that you say everyone was so fashion forward, and then they're also like, oh, but we love buying things secondhand and thrifting, and so that seems like that wouldn't go together. But
no, they like make it. It's almost like those things you like look at and you're like, no way that would work, and then somebody
makes it
makes it work.
Yeah.
But I was like,
that's like such a wild story, though.
Yeah. Well, and I told you, like, we found someone. I went up to her and I was humbled so quickly. Oh, what are you talking about?
She's like, I don't even know what your school is. What are you saying?
That's so wild.
And she was like clearly Danish. She was like very tall, blonde, had an accent. I don't even know if she really understood what I was saying. Like, it was like,
you're like so excited. Yeah. She's like, why is this guy so excited to see me?
Okay, Mira, was there any other things that you did that we missed, or anything else that you recommend about Copenhagen?
The only thing I would say, this is like a disclaimer, is if you're buying a train ticket, verify that it actually came through, because the last day, literally going to the train station to go to Amsterdam, I didn't get like the like Copenhagen card. So I think most cities or like places in Europe, you can like just use your credit card sometimes, and that like counts as your public transportation like fee. Copenhagen, you have to have like one of the metro cards. Like, you can't just use like your credit card and tap to get on like the train or whatever. So if you're only buying like a one-way ticket, you have to make sure like you have it, because my last day, I thought I bought the ticket. I had the whole receipt and everything. We get on the train and the guys come around to check it, and they're like, this is like a receipt. Like, this isn't your actual ticket. I'm like, okay, but it says like, it clearly is like my ticket. I tried to buy a ticket. Yeah. Like, this is proof. And they were not super lenient about that. And so I got fined. It was
$750
krones which is $110.
No.
My last day. Yeah. Just wait, for
that's rough.
Not like verifying that I had like a ticket with me.
Wow. Yeah. I cannot believe they didn't even let you off with a warning.
I know.
You like obviously are not from there and you thought you bought it. Yeah. Like that's harsh.
Yeah.
So how much are the Metro cards? Like you have to buy a Metro card and then buy the ticket through
So you buy the Metro card and then you have to like almost add, it's like a gift card. Like you add money to it. And like that was probably the only place that I mean, at least that I'm aware of that, like, you just, like, they don't just take, like, your credit card just to tap and, like, that counts as, like, your train
Yeah, I've never
pass.
Heard of that. That's so weird.
Yeah. So I, like, got fine. So I would say, honestly, do the Copenhagen card. Like, most of these, like, cities have, like, specific, like, cards that let you do, like, all transportation. Get the Copenhagen card or just, like, be really, really sure you had your ticket.
Yeah.
Because it spit out that receipt, but it never spit out my, I guess, actual tickets.
I would never would have thought anything of that too. Yeah. It's like a printout receipt. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Grab my receipt and go. And wouldn't have even thought twice about it.
It was a very unlucky situation.
Oh
so
my God.
That would be my only piece of advice is like, if you're going to ride the Metro, you are confident you have a ticket.
Mira, do you have any other trips planned or any other travels coming up in your horizon?
Yeah, I'm going to Colorado in a couple weeks. Also to meet someone I don't know super well.
I thought you were going with your college roommate.
No.
You're not going to see Abby?
No, well, I'll meet up with her there. Okay. But I'm actually going – there's just this girl in college, and I never was friends with her in college. But then we followed each other literally, like, senior week. And I saw she and I did, like, so many similar things. Like, she was really big into Young Life. And she's serving at a Young Life camp in Colorado.
Okay.
So we were just, like, in touch, like, how's post-grad been? How's this? And she was like, if you ever want to come out and, like, volunteer at this camp, like, you could totally, like, I'll send you, like, the weekends. And I was like, yep, send me the weekends.
So Mira literally is somebody that
she
never
yes
says
girl.
No. And I love that about you. It's so amazing. Because then you do all these fun and spontaneous things. And I'm like, I wish I was doing stuff like that. Like, I want to go to a camp in Colorado. Yeah.
So that's, like, what I'm going to do for a weekend in, like, mid-November. So it'll be
that
cold, but
so
that's my next trip.
And you just went to Seattle.
Yes,
and had
I did.
A great time there.
That was super fun.
Yeah, Mira's all over you guys. I'm telling you. She's going to definitely be a reoccurring guest because
you're
always popping around somewhere new.
Well, if Kelsey can send me that article on, like, how to avoid the depression when you come back,
I'd
really appreciate that.
You're just, like, trying to fake the post-travel depression by, like, always planning a new trip.
Yeah, honestly, that's the way to do it. Yeah. Yeah, just have something to look forward to or, like, just hold on to your memories from your trip as long as possible, and that can cure your sadness.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for coming on, Mira.
I was so excited because I always listen. I drive a lot for my job, so, like, this podcast is just always, like, getting me to my next destination.
I was
like,
just telling them this morning about how you and Joe talk about Dirt Boy.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. That is the funniest. I, like, had to almost pull over the car because it was so funny.
Oh, my God. That's in our Tulsa episode for those listening. Yeah. Yeah.
That's
y'all
so
need
funny.
To listen to the Tulsa episode if you're like, what are they talking about right now?
That's unlike any other episode we've done. So.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, sometimes I don't know if I'm just, like, cracking up because I, like, know you. So it's, like, really funny to, like, know my friend doing that, or if that's, like, actually, like, a really funny story. Like, so Joe was, like, cracking up, and I'm like, okay, I feel like that is really funny.
That's good
to know. Also, Kelsey's just impression of him, like, made me laugh.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm dying. No, because we wonder that too. We're like, do we just think we're funny or do other people think we're funny?
Delusional?
We still don't know. Yeah, we're probably a little delusional.
I laugh,
but
again, I don't know if I'm just
Mira.
Delusional with you.
Thanks for thinking we're funny. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
I don't know if we're, like, still recording. I, like, when I listen to these podcasts, I almost feel like I'm a part of it. So
this was, like, your big moment.
Yeah. People have said that, though.
yesterday I told Allie, I'm like, oh, I guess I like know a lot about you, but you don't know a lot about me because I listen to this like weekly, but like you're so busy. We actually don't talk that often.
Yeah, I feel like you get all my life updates, yes. but I actually don't get any of yours. So we don't know
what's going on. Yeah, I was like bringing up all these things. And then like, well, actually, I only know this because I listen every week.
No, I love it. I love it. That's what we're here for.